Dear audience, welcome to the Soap Power Chat. In today's episode, we are discussing about public relations practices in South Asia, with particular focus in India and other countries, also in Nepal. Joining us today is Dr. T. Vinay Kumar, a renowned public relations and event management specialist in India, who is also the national president-elect of Public Relations Council of India, also the chairman of Global Communication Conclave, that is taking place in March 2020. Please allow me to welcome him. Welcome to this show, Dr. Kumar.
Thank you.
How have you been?
Yeah, fine.
Well, you have been traveling a lot, and most often you travel to, you know, interact on the issues related to public relations, image building and all, event management and advertisement. How do you observe the state of public relation practices in South Asia? Particularly, you know, you worked in India. What is your reflection?
See, I've started my career in before four decades. I'm completing 40 years in advertising and PR and reputation management next year. See, so far I've seen the transformation taking place from print media to the social media. The print media, when I started, print media was dominating, and we were sure that we will get results using that medium. Then came the television. Television, we were doubtful how effective the medium will be, but we proved wrong. Then came with the all-powerful social media that really made a lot of difference. Actually, I am still a beginner in this thing, in the public relations in the domain, because such is the pace of the changes taking place in trends, media and technology. One, earlier we can have perfect control on print and electronic media. We could disseminate what we wanted to communicate. We were actually reigning like kingmakers. We can create planned stories. We can manipulate news. We can do a lot of things. But now the scene is totally different. The power is with the masses. The every person, every individual is a publishing house. He can do whatever he wants. He can create and destroy big emperors, big empires. That is the power of social media now. So when you talk about social media, the most important thing is the knowledge. You should have perfect knowledge of what is happening around, about your competitor, about your activities, about your staff's activities, about the policies and priorities of your institution. That is very important. Unless you don't have that knowledge, perfect knowledge, you cannot perform. So there's a very interesting advertisement which appeared in long back in Economic Times. In that advertisement, a cat was shown sitting very close to a very ferocious and very a dog, which was sitting very close to the dog, the cat. It was very cool and sitting very without any disturbances or hindrances. And the caption said, "The knowledge of power." Because that is the power of knowledge. So now we have to know the intricacies of the happenings around us. Then only we can perfectly communicate.
Well, Dr. Kumar, where are organizations in this region? You are observing, you know, public relations practices in many countries, including India. You are here in Nepal for many workshops and seminars. Where are organizations? Where are corporates? Where are governments utilizing these all tools in a positive way for constructive, you know, communication?
This social media is a new one. So most of the people are still aware of the impact or the importance of that. That is lacking in all these places, I should say. We don't have perfect practitioners in that media and experts in that media. So we are still learning session. We are still learning. So that what is happening is, you know, suppose if you want to communicate a particular issue or a program of your government or a social organization, you will have to perfectly plan it, and you will have to decide where to go, how to go. So all homework you will have to do, lot of homework you will have to do. Then only you will get the correct group or the correct message passed. That is creating problems, because still we are learning, as I told you. So lot of things to be yet to be learned. In fact, people are usually going for a blanket communication. Now, you should be very fragmented, very focused communication you should have. Then only you can reach your objectives.
Could you also highlight the basics of focused communications, the major indicators of, you know, effective communication for any organization?
As I told you, knowledge is the best, the number one thing. Second is the networking. You should have networking. Networking or social engineering is actually, with using the networking, you can create contacts, you can create goodwill, you can create, so this social media, you can have a good rapport with them. So that way you can very effectively make it. Second one is the image building. Image actually, it's not how you are dressed up or which car you are using or things like that. It is a concept of the people, concept of the public. So in that case, you should be very careful. That is to be, the image building is done in a very slow and steady manner, giving a lot of time and effort. Then only you can create that perfect image which you wanted to create. If you don't have that image, your stakeholders will not recognize you in that manner. So that is very important, another thing. Second thing is you should adapt to the changes. Changes is taking place in a very fast manner. So you, as I told you, the newsrooms, actually the newsrooms are now your personal device or a mobile phone. The importance of newsrooms are gone. And people want, they are very choosy now. They can have any news, any matter, anything they want. So lot of options are there, unlike in the past, where only TV or newspaper was the source of information. Now it is your mobile phone. You can get anything and everything in that. So it is a power of that communication devices has changed. So that is the most important thing. Any communicator, when they do the communication, they should listen to or attend to.
But then there are criticisms, social media outlets are not properly utilized in a constructive way. There are many distractions through social media as well. What are your suggestions to the organizations or individuals so that they could utilize these outlets appropriately without destroying anything, without harming anyone?
No, like every good thing, there'll be a bad thing. This is the other side of the social media's good effective usage. For that, there is no such control as such control has come. So some governments, some people, they have made lot of rules and regulations, which is, I think it is not correct, because you should not control social media as such, because social media has the power to make, or as I told you, create or destroy that they have the control and the power. So when you deal with social media, you should be very, very careful. So the norms, the conditions to be fixed with great study, lot of efforts, you will have to, then only you have to do that. Otherwise, what will happen is that can go wrong, because you can't control, you don't have a perfect control on that. What you can do is you can ban the internet. That is the only way to control it. Otherwise, how are you going to control it? So lot of controls, of course, governments are bringing in controls in different manners, but effectively to control that, you have to learn about it more, then only you can get a perfect control over the messages as disseminating.
What are the major areas of your work with the Public Relations Council of India?
Public Relations Council of India is a body of advertising, PR, media, HR and allied industries. Our main objective is communicating for a better world. That is our tagline. So we are trying to bring in latest trends and technologies into our country, and also to share our views and messages to other people in other parts of the country. We are traveling a lot. We are creating our World Communicators Council. We are starting chapters. Already Nepal has got a chapter. Like that, we have started in Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Dubai. We are going on spreading this message. That is our major objective.
Well, Public Relations Council of India is organizing a global communication conclave scheduled for 2020, March 6 to 7 in Kochi, Kerala. Could you share us with the major objectives of this conclave? What are you going to discuss?
Our theme we have fixed for this conclave is PR Beyond 2020. Because as I told you, a lot of changes are taking place, and we should be equipped with the knowledge and the power. So we are going to have conferences, we are going to have speakers meetings, we are going to have panel discussions, and lot of eminent personalities from the media, from the corporate sector, from the government sector, and from the industry. They are going to participate in that. We are inviting from all over the world, not from India alone, all over the world. Experts are going to come and disseminate knowledge, that which will definitely help to improve the acumen as well as the ability of the participants.
What is your projection beyond 2020? How would you look at the practice of communication on PR after 2020?
You should be more responsible, that is what I have to say. That is lacking now. In government as well as in private sector, in the corporate sector, the responsibility is lacking now. You should be more responsible. We are aiming, we are planning, we are hoping that we could achieve that with this session.
Do you mean that the corporate and social organization sectors, they are lacking knowledge on identifying, you know, appropriate communication channels? Also, they are not making distinction between advertisement and PR, resulting to a very forceful messaging and compelling audience to receive whatever they shop.
No, the advertising and PR, no, it's totally, they are totally two different domains. Most of the people are taking it as both advertising and PR. Like I was told by one of my friends in Nepal, no, this advertising agency is expected to do PR also in Nepal. That is a wrong notion, wrong concept. Advertising is actually a paid form of message communicating, whereas PR is a unpaid, non-paid form of communicating, where you, in advertising, you have perfect control on what is happening, because you can create whatever you wanted to say and it is preset. Whereas PR, actually you are disseminating an information, and the lot of discussions will take on that, lot of opinions will be formed, lot of criticisms will be there. So you'll have to answer, you will have to attend all those things. So advertising is a one-way communication, I should say, because you cannot respond back. But PR is not like that. PR is, it covers the masses. Whereas advertising is, you are covering only a particular group of persons or a customer base. That is the difference.
What are the key areas that one can involve in public relations on part of the organizations?
Now, public relations, as I told you, in India, we have the CSR, Corporate Social Responsibility. That has become a very important role in India, because all the public limited companies should have a certain amount for this CSR activities. So the role of the public relations or corporate communication manager, earlier it was to write notes or speeches for their bosses, or to book tickets or things like that. Now it is changed totally. Now he is in the direct, most of them are in the director board. They are the decision makers now, because corporate communication has attained such a big responsible position. So in corporates and governments, they should have good people to direct, to control the flow of information. Then only you will have the real results.
How do you see the governments? Are they performing well, approaching media and approaching public relations tools in this region?
No, the governments, no, they could cover certain things earlier. Sorry. Now that is not the case. Now everything is open to everyone, because the right to information has come. So you cannot be alone, or you cannot be away from the public. You are perfectly in their eyes. You are seen, you are heard. So it is very difficult to keep away from them. So you should be very, very transparent. Then only you can get the desired results.
And any studies or research from PRCI or other wings, you know, there are tools like right to information and all, but you know, there is always question about transparency and accountability on part of the governments. Is there any reference?
We are planning to conduct a research on this topic. Soon we are going to do that. We are already into social media. We are doing a lot of social activities. PRC is definitely interfering in problems and activities of the society and the government. We have started in interfering in that. Slowly and steadily we want to come up with that. We already have an academic division in our BRCI, which is preparing the curriculum for the PR students, PR and journalism students. We are publishing books and publications for them, and also we have a pool of experts with us, the institutions can take the professors or the speakers from our pool. So that, like that, now we are slowly and steadily we are coming into the main focus.
from the beginning you're focusing on the appropriate utilization of social media. What are the, you know, do you think that, you know, the users, be individuals or organizations, they do understand the algorithms, how social media, especially that of the Facebook, presents in the open societies like ours, you know, are appropriately utilized? Or how can they better utilize the social media without paying it, without spending much money, and they can utilize this tool as a PR communication?
And as I told you, one should know what is happening. Actually, the basics of the social media, one should learn. Then only they can perform. What is happening is, we all are feeling that Facebook is free. So you can put anything in Facebook, that will give you results. No, that is wrong. That is very wrong. Because a lot of information is everyone is giving information or photos or news to Facebook and other social media. But who is seeing all these things? If you don't want to see that, you can easily eliminate it. You can. So you should be more focused. You should know the algorithms of Facebook and Google, as I told you. And you should know how to use it, where to use it, and things like that. This, the information, the user data is very important, as I told you. So you should know how to use it perfectly. Then only it will produce the desired results. Because you should listen to the social media. You should also listen. You should have the near time, real time response you should give. Because if you are not seen or heard every day, you will lose your prominence. You will be out of focus, and finally you will be out from the scene. So you should be very careful. You should use the latest techniques like animation or automation or artificial intelligence, the latest tools, effectively to make it more better and perfect.
How do you observe the state of media literacy? Any type of media, be print or radio, TV, and social media, are public on their part literate enough to utilize these outlets?
I don't think so, especially this latest social media, because as I told you, it's only in the beginning stage. It has to go a long way. So most of the people are still not aware or not fully aware of the advantages or the utilization, how to utilize it properly. So some more learning, some more sessions to be done, some more dissemination of data should be done. Then only it will be make it perfect. But print and electronic media was there for quite some time. So print and social media lost their prominence now. That is the unfortunate scene. But I should not say that they have lost it completely. Slowly, but they are coming out with a lot of new innovations and techniques. Like for example, this radio, once upon a time it was a very powerful medium before the TV or at the time of the newspapers. Now after that they lost their prominence. Now they are coming back with this FM. FM stations are there. So almost everyone is listening to radio now. So like that, changes, sometimes it will be good, sometimes it will be bad.
What are your recommendations to the organizations for their effective presence in the market?
Training is very important. They should train their people. Now that is not happening.
Do you think that they are investing much on training?
They will have to. They will have to invest much on it. What I should say now, training of course is taking place in various aspects. But this media, they are not giving more prominence, or they are not giving the due consideration. So as I told you, anyone can create or destruct an organization using the social media. So they should be more aware, more training, and more information should be given to the people, because a person may be a very lower level, a staff may be a very lower level in an organization. Suppose he puts a news in the social media, sometimes he will be thinking that it is very harmless, but it can create a lot of problems to the organization. So you should be very, very careful. You should be trained from scratch to the top. Should be trained. That is not taking place now. That should be done. Then only you can really use and you can protect your organization rather than using it for your benefit.
Coming back to the Global Communication Conclave 2020, March 6 to 7. So what are you expecting from that conference very quickly?
This conclave, we hope, will be an eye-opener to the PR and corporate communication sector, academics and advertising people, because we are very careful. We are selecting good people from the fraternity who are practitioners, and they will definitely give a lot of insights to the people who are attending it. We are hopeful.
There are many interesting issues, but we are coming to the end of the show. Any final thoughts that you want to say to our audience that I have left to ask you very quickly?
So I told you, we should be very, very, very up to date on these informations, and then only you can any time that was the case. But now the social media is changing, revolutionizing the entire concept of media. So understand the power of social media, act with and be friendly with that. No, don't make it an enemy, and you will definitely come through all the problems you are facing now.
Well, Dr. Binay Kumar, it was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you, Lakshman.
Dear audience, time now to wrap up the show. Keep watching us. See you next week. Namaste.